16, 2013, at the Preston Bradley Hall of the Chicago Culture Center, one of the most prestigious halls in Chicago. Quoting the website of General Consulate, the reception was attended by more than 350 guests, representative of the government institution of the state of Illinois and city of Chicago, members of diplomatic corps, representative of Serbian organizations, businessmen, and members of the diaspora. The reception was also attended by dignitaries of the Serbian Orthodox Church, led by pontiff of New Gracanica-Midwestern Diocese of America, Bishop Longin, and Abbot Methodius of the Monastery of Chilandar. The official part of the festivity began by reading the letter of congratulation from the Pat Quinn, Governor of State of Illinois, Chicago Mayor Rahm Emanuel, Illinois Attorney General Lisa Madigan. Also, letters of congratulation was received by Brandon Reilly, Alderman of 42nd Ward, where General Consulate is located, and also from Maria Pappas, Cook County Treasurer. The gathering was then addressed by Consul General Desko Nikitovic, who greeted the guests. At the beginning of his speech, Mr. Nikitovic introduced the guest to the symbolism of the date celebrated as Serbian National Day and stated our most important foreign policy priorities, particularly underscoring the question of Kosovo and position of Republic of Serbia regarding the resolution of this problem.
The National Day of Serbia is celebrated on February 15 because Serbia adopted a very modern constitution called Sretenjski Ustav on February 15, 1835. However, because Serbia was previously a part of Yugoslavia until 2007, we did not celebrate February 15th as the national day. So in recent history, we began to mark this important historic event as our national day. Last year, Serbia elected a new president, new parliament, and coalition government was formed. The people of Serbia, while distanced from the struggle in the past, continue to experience a challenging period following the global economic crisis and mismanagement in its economy. There are several top priorities for Serbia's new government: improving the economy, resolving the Kosovo status, and accession to the European Union are the top three priorities. Also of crucial importance is the establishment of a modern and law-abiding society. Fighting organized crime and corruption has been one of most significant difficulties. Despite the current economic difficulties, we understand that the global economy became an indispensable way for prosperity and economic development. This is why Serbia values its economic relations with the European Union, United States, Russia, as well China and India. We know that this is an era of a new economy and the new technologies which demand a different approach to world affairs, politics, and the business. There is absolutely no question that Serbia will again become a prominent business, cultural, and tourist destination in Southeast Europe with a prosperous economy and a strong democracy. Serbia established diplomatic relations with the United States 132 years ago on October 14, 1881. With the exception of 1999, when United States led a military campaign against Serbia, our relations were always strong. Serbia was one of the most loyal allies to the United States of America, both world wars, and in particular in the Second World War, when Serbia strongly resisted the Nazi invasion and deterred Hitler from further infestation into Europe. Today, our two countries have a disagreement on the delicate issue of Kosovo and Metohija, the southern province of Serbia. Serbia always regarded Kosovo as its birthplace, and separating Kosovo from Serbia would significantly alter Serbian culture and history. It is very difficult for most Americans to appreciate, the role of history in the daily lives of long-standing European nations. We are ready to resolve practical issues with the Kosovo, but we will not recognize its independence. We believe that the importance of the national law and the viability of United Nations principles, and we expect that the international community take a fair and balanced approach to this issue. As relations between two countries could be complex, many times relations between people and their representative, their respective governments are very different. Americans visiting or living in Serbia always enjoy unmatched hospitality. I can personally recall numerous exchanges with U.S. diplomats posted at the U.S. Embassy in Belgrade who truly enjoyed their experience in Serbia. Americans of Serbian descent visiting Serbia for the first time experience a strong and immediate emotional connection with the land of their ancestors. These experiences will undoubtedly continue to translate into positive economic relations. Many U.S. companies successfully invested in our economy, and the United States is one of the largest foreign investors in Serbia. The U.S. Embassy in Belgrade is very active in promoting economic development in Serbia. Our consulate in Chicago recently opened a commercial section that will further improve trade and commerce. Our economic relations are very strong. This is the reason that gives us hope for resolving issues of which we disagree. Our consulate greatly enjoys the hospitality of Chicago, City of Chicago, and State of Illinois. We truly appreciate the assistance from Mayor Emanuel and Governor Quinn in improving exchanges between Serbia and the State of Illinois. We very much value Belgrade's sister city relationship with Chicago and strong cooperation between Serbia and the State of Illinois. We are looking forward to leading the further improvement of relations with the United States, and all of you are helping us to achieve this goal, and I sincerely thank you for this. I would like to thank our Chicagoland community for the exceptional support that they offered to us for almost a decade. We have tried to provide the best service to our citizens. In return, you have responded with a great generosity when I needed your expertise, services, or goods. I have to emphasize how much I have enjoyed working with all of you individually and collectively, with various Serbian organizations and with the new Gracanica Diocese and its outstanding leader, Bishop Longin. Together, we have managed to overcome decades-long division which previously permeated the Serbian diaspora. I am so proud of our cooperation. Thank you, Bishop Longin, for your most sincere support. And thank you, my fellow Serbs, for your trust and the friendship.